event is being organized by the Office of the Secretary to the Government of the Federation and will hold at the banquet hall of the Presidential Villa. President Muhammadu Buhari has already indicated that some of the new ministers will have to operate without portfolios. Senate President Dr. Bukola Saraki has named the chairmen and deputy chairmen of the 65 Senate committees to oversee various ministries, departments and agencies of government. 41 of the committees are being chaired by APC senators, while 24 committees are headed by the PDP. Fuel queues being witnessed across some major cities in the country may soon disappear if the latest efforts of the Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation are anything to go by. The NNPC says the federal government has approved the payment of 413 billion naira to oil marketers as outstanding payment for subsidy claims. They also say they have injected additional volumes into the market in order to ensure zero fuel queues ahead of the festive season and beyond. And outside Nigeria, it seems the US and the UK are in agreement with Russia over the Sanai plane crash, as officials from both sides say intelligence reports suggest the Russian plane that crashed in Egypt, killing all 224 people on board, may have been brought down by a bomb. They, however, say they are yet to reach a formal conclusion. Britain earlier suspended flights to and from the resort of Sharm el-Sheikh, from where the flights had departed. Egypt also has dismissed claims by militants linked to Islamic State that they brought down the plane, and Russian experts say it's too early to tell. Those were the news headlines. For details of those stories and others, please go to our website, channelstelevision.com. And back to you guys. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, what do you have to say about the game, about the Arsenal?
I think Yemi has a point that pressure can induce certain results.
Wide margin defeats.
But yeah, but that's too wide a margin.
Mm. Considering the fact that Arsenal knew what was at stake when they go to the Allianz Arena, so you would have expected them to be a little bit more tactical in their approach in terms of defending, particularly. But
indeed, and you know that they come. That this is after five wins at the EPL.
Yeah.
So
question marks there for Arsene Wenger.
Do you think they can actually get out of that group?
I don't think so.
It's anybody's guess now, right?
Anyway, thank you so much, Olumide, for spending time with us on the show. All right, let's move on, guys. We're talking about... Yeah, we can't stop laughing.
I'm tempted to say what? Yeah, I'm tempted to remind you guys that even last season, Real Madrid beat the same Bayern. Home and away, 6-0 on aggregate. So big teams, when they are under pressure, it happens.
Yeah, that's lost, on aggregate. But 5-1 at once.
5-0. It wasn't even 5-1.
No,
it was
5-0. Yeah, 5-0.
At the Allianz Arena. And the same team that you've just beaten at home, 2-0, and you now.
I'm just telling you that when teams play and one is under pressure.
The difference between Real Madrid and Bayern then was that it was home and away. But this one, I mean, you won at home, thinking if you go there, at least get a draw or reduce the margin, but not 5-1.
Okay. I just told you someone beat another person. All right, let's move on. Okay, let's get into all that we're doing this morning. It's interesting that a lot of people are already talking to us about the UEFA Champions League. Some, you know, telling us to talk about other sports. All right, we'll do what we can. You can send us a mail at channelssportsthismorning@channelstv.com. Of course, doing that, you can get your views across to us. We will like to read your thoughts out loud. Of course, on Facebook, it is Channels iPhone Sports, and on Twitter, it is at channels_sports. That's how you can get your thoughts across to us. Let's see if we can get one or two people already talking. If I read this, you guys will accuse me, but maybe I'll just go ahead and read it. Also, Michael Olushola says, good morning, guys. Wishing the Golden Eaglets all the best today against the Mexican. This is the game against Bayern and Arsenal. The referee was biased. I don't know where he got that from.
Yeah.
But is he sure that's
the comment. Goal was correctly offside. I mean, it was supposed to be an offside, but I think that's actually.
That was a talking point, yeah. Mm-hmm. Because some would have felt if that goal had gone in, maybe.
Forget it. Five is five.
All right. Okay. Okay. All right, let's talk about the FIFA Under 17 World Cup. At least we can agree on that.
Tonight is the night.
Friday in Nigeria. Early hours of the next day, we're going to keep vigil and see if, you know, we'll do one on the Mexicans. All right, match details for you. 12 a.m. Friday, November 6th. Estadio Municipal in the city of Concepcion. The stadium capacity is 33,000. The surface is grass. And match officials from the United Arab Emirates will officiate that game. Okay, some other things. Head-to-heads between Nigeria and Mexico. We've played three times. Mm-hmm. We lost once. That's in 87. Mm-hmm. We beat them twice.
Yeah.
We beat them twice here in the United Arab Emirates. So we're hoping that our good luck will continue when we take to the field and play against them. So two matches in 2013, so that's it. 2013 we played twice. One at the group stage, one in the semi-final, then the other one was in 1987, way back then. I remember that team got to the final. Got to the final. We just didn't win that tournament. It was actually in Canada.
Yeah, in Canada.
Canada. It was the under 20 that played in Chile.
In Chile.
And I was about to tell you the story about the stadium that we're going to play in. In Chile 87, star-studded Flying Eagles team that was celebrated. Yesterday we went down memory lane, talked about that stadium, Estadio Municipal in Concepcion. That particular stadium was where Brazil defeated us 4-0. That team, let me just tell you, Nduka Ogbadi was in that team. Victor Egbunoba, Jonathan Akpobore, was Adeolu Adekola, Etimesin. Remember, that was the period where Etimesin was attacked by armed robbers, was shot. Willie Opara, that said he was going to be the Cards. And Tony Bito, he said something. He said, before those guys left, we celebrated them like world champions. Mm. And anytime we do that, that particular team gets to disappoint us. And I remember I was doing that same thing with the last under 20 squad. Mm-hmm. We already said that this was going to be the team that was going to first time. And it didn't happen. This team unheralded. We didn't say anything about it. I remember me and you criticizing them, talking about Wakali and Osimhen, the only players in that squad. But now we're all celebrating them.
Yeah, it's good.
Okay,
it's a
good one because of what you just said. I think since we didn't celebrate them, they're definitely going to win the trophy.
Yeah.
It's fair when you don't put too much expectations in them. You know, it takes away that pressure, quote unquote. So they go out there, express themselves, and who knows, they just might come back with a trophy.
Let's wait for tonight first.
Okay,
we'll wait for tonight. We know what's going to happen.
And hopefully, we'll be talking about Nigeria in the final. We'll also wish our African brothers best of luck.
We wish them. Mali. All right.
Okay.
Let's move on. And of course, the Niger Professional Football League reshared games were decided. So definitely we'll be having some of the results right about now. Of course, we talked about the game that will be played in Lagos. Sunshine Stars against Rangers.
Rescheduled matches in the Niger Professional Football League. The outcome of this.
Resembles that of Arsenal. Okay.
I know you were going to say that.
You have to break that in. Sunshine Stars are now on 59 points, courtesy of that. And also, as a result of this victory, Tunde Adeniji is now the highest goal scorer in the Niger Professional with 16 goals. He has stayed on 14 goals for a long time. Now he got a brace yesterday. And we talked about Sunshine having a lot of players. In fact, Sunshine Stars contribute more to the home base Super Eagles. And that's why some of us are wondering why they are where they are. But of course, that game wasn't able to take them, you know, beyond the fifth position. So Ifeanyi Uba also defeated
El Kanami Warriors.
El Kanami lost. But it's interesting to know that Junior International, Ifeanyi Matthew, scored in that. And Ifeanyi Matthew is one player that a lot of people are looking at, a creative midfielder, scored a wonderful free kick from reports. Scored a wonderful free kick in that one. Then FC Taraba and Nasarawa United, the remaining 9 minutes.
you go and sit down and you're watching the game and you just have nine minutes to play. Do you expect to see fireworks in 9 minutes?
It could happen. But in this case,
because at first they were not happy that you know the fans had to disrupt the game and everything. Not really the fans; they were the ones who said they weren't going to play anyway. So at the end of the day, they needed to finish playing that game. I think the game of of the moment, Sunshine Stars against Rangers. I knew the Sunshine Stars, definitely they have the edge, but I didn't know the scoreline was going to be that bad. Huge. I mean, judging from the fact that most of the goals came in the second half, you know, according to what the coach said because the captain, Okay Odita, was actually sent off 33rd minute, so the game...